Well, hello everyone. It's the final Tuesday Tips Live of the year here at Digital DJ Tips. I should have my Christmas hat on really, shouldn't I? But I haven't. We're here and we're here to help you with your DJing questions, queries, challenges and so on. We have no lesson for you this week because we haven't got a Thursday Q&A live on Thursday, and then we haven't got one until the 11th of January 2022, which is when we'll be back for the next Tuesday Tips, 2 weeks today. 3 weeks today, is that? Yeah, 3 weeks today, awesome. So we're going to do an open house. Any questions, anything you want to talk about for the next hour is what we're going to do today to end off the year. What's been a really interesting year, right, in DJing? All kinds of stuff going on this year, not least the great gear shortage, as I'm sure it will no doubt come to be known over the past few months, which looks like it's going to carry on into 2022 and beyond, if you ask me. So an interesting year. Lockdown, not lockdown, lockdown again. Let us know your thoughts on that. But let's talk about big issues. Let's talk about 2021. Let's talk about next year. But let's also just talk about whatever it is you're stuck with in your DJing that you need help with. It's an open house today. And I'm here to hang out with you guys and girls for the next hour. Now, as ever, if you enjoy what you see and you want to be part of it, go and click on the link there, or rather type the link there into your browser, digitaldjtips.com/join. You get a copy of our book, you get a copy of our gear guide, but also you get our weekly newsletter, which is the best way to improve your DJing. And that's totally free, all of it. So if you want to ask a question today, hashtag ask, please. Hashtag ASK. In order to join in. Hello to Mixmaster G in the locked down Netherlands. Hello to Martin, who says Merry Christmas, and to you. Hello to Jorge, big hug from Portugal. Happy holidays to the whole team. Thank you, Jorge. To Godfred, says the same to you too. Christian, hello everyone again. Hello to Ian and Adam, Salvation Drum and Bass over there in Essex. To Kevin, to You Don't Like My Music. Happy solstice. Good point. The days are getting longer from here on in for us in the Northern Hemisphere. That's good news. So thank you for that. UK apparently will be back in lockdown, according to Kevin. I've not looked at the news today, but that would be no surprise were it the case. Hello to Technobeat over there in the Philippines. Hope you're surviving with the typhoons that are sweeping through at the moment. White Privilege Cat, no gears. Not sure what you mean by that, but anyway, hello. Hello to JT69 United. Hello, Phil. Hope you're fine. Hello to James and to Ivan, to Portugal, who's saying apparently Jorge in Portugal saying the clubs are closing again there as well. Miggy's in the Philippines as well. Hello to Soul Dust Sounds over there in India. A brother named Sherm, not seen you for a little while. Hello over there in Arizona. To DJ Black Eagle, to Aaron, Mark One, who says good Christmas. Have a nice Christmas, everyone. White Privilege Cat, nice beard. Yeah, I need a shave, I've got to be honest. And Driver John saying all the best as well. Listen, it's lovely to hear all your Christmas greetings. It's lovely to send them back at you. But this is all about your questions. What questions we can help you with for the next hour here at Digital DJ Tips, or half hour, or 10 minutes. As soon as they're all done, I'm off early for a mince pie. So do ask away. Maybe you're stuck on stuff to do with your DJ gear and you can't figure out how your latest gear purchase works. We've got an XDJ RX3 set up in the studio here today that we're playing with. Maybe you need some help with your music. Getting the music, organizing the music, shortlisting it, playing it, turning it into great DJ sets. Maybe there's a certain technique you're stuck with. You're struggling with your scratching. You are mulling over your mixing. Then it could be something to do with your performing. It could be like you get stage fright, or the last gig you played was a disaster and you want to know why. Or you might need help with promoting yourself, getting your name out there, your relationships with club owners and promoters and DJs. We will help you with all of it. That's what we do. So any questions on anything at all to do with your DJing, please ask away, and I will try and answer them for you today or in the next hour or so. So our first question live is from Blue Boy. Can I use a Mackie Pro FX 12 V2 microphone as a DJ microphone? So the Mackie Pro FX 12 V2, is that a mixer? Did I read that right? Can I use the Mackie Pro FX? Let me just have a little look at that question again, because there's so many questions coming in. It's stroll past. Oh, yeah, it's not a microphone at all. I thought it was a mixer. Can I use a Mackie Pro FX Studio mixer as a DJ controller? No, not really. It's a USB mixer, so it's got a sound card built in. So you could probably kind of use it as a DJ mixer in some way. But Not really. It's not really made for that. Interestingly enough, we've got a big article coming up on the difference between, if you like, normal mixers and DJ mixers. So watch out for that. But no, I mean, you can use any MIDI gear and any audio gear in some capacity with DJ software, but it certainly wouldn't be a first choice for me by any means. Hey, give it a go if you want to. Certainly, we'd get some sound coming out of it for sure. Nice joke. You don't like my music. Let's not. DJ Black Eagle, what would be a nice way to build a habit into live streaming? I want to start live streaming, but I don't know how. So I think you're asking, you want to start live streaming, but you don't know how. Right, so we've got so much stuff on Digital DJ Tips that can help you if you want to learn to live stream. Let's just leg over to the website and have a look. If you go to the, oh, by the way, if you haven't entered the census, we've got $40,000 worth of prizes, including what you can see in the middle there, a full four channel, four deck Denon DJ Pro system. But we've also got an XDJ RX3, just like the one that you see here. And we've got five Pioneer DDJ Flex 6s, two Pioneer S7 mixers, a Reloop mixer, Allen & Heath DJ gear, a Serato tractor. We've got loads and loads and loads of gear and software to give away. So do come and enter. Just go to the site, click on the Global DJ Census banner, and get your voice heard. Fill in the DJ survey, and you'll get a free entry into that $40,000 prize draw. You could be lucky this Christmas, but you won't be if you don't enter. So, finding out about live streaming, click the little magnifying glass in the top corner of Digital DJ Tips and type in live streaming, all one word. If you type in as badly as I did, you'll see nothing. But assuming you spell it properly, you will get literally dozens of articles on live streaming to help you get started. And the one, if you've never live streamed before, that you want to go to is the Ultimate Guide to DJ Live Streaming in 2021. Scroll down, and you'll find that this article contains everything you need, along with links to lots and lots of other articles on Digital DJ Tips to help you. It literally talks you through beginning to end on how to get started live streaming. It's a really interesting subject to get involved in if you haven't been involved in it before. There's lots to learn, but it's all perfectly doable. And this is based on our experience. We've done hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of live streams. Indeed, there's me setting one up on location. So do come and take a look at that article. But if you're ready to really let us help you, if you go into the DJ courses section of Digital DJ Tips and slide down to the deep dive courses, the specialized courses down near the bottom, there's a course called DJ Live Streaming Made Easy, where I teach you over several hours how to do it on your phone, on your laptop, on your tablet, and even to set up a full studio like the one I'm in now talking to you with this camera angle and that camera angle. Hello. And all the multiple cameras and views and so on that you expect in a proper studio. So if you want help with that, there's two ways of getting it. Thank you very much for the question, DJ Black Eagle. P. Hines, hello, says, why won't tractor, i.e. native instruments, focus on elastic beat gridding? To me, the most important thing, in my opinion, is to catch up with the competition. So elastic beat gridding, sometimes known as flexible beat gridding, is where you have a track which isn't a set BPM. Now, we're not talking about a track that goes literally from 120 to 60 to 80 to whatever, although some DJ software can handle that okay. We're talking about the tracks that are basically one BPM, but they've got a live drummer. And live drummers are notorious for not sticking to the beat. They might speed up a bit when they're getting excited and slow down a bit when the chorus has ended. So you find like funk, soul, rock, a lot of older music. Just you can't put a beat grid over it in the same way as you can with electronic music. Now, a beat grid is simply the DJ software's way of saying, look, here's a beat, here's the beginning of a beat, here's the beginning of a bar, here's the next beat, here's the next beat, all the way through the track. And that allows you to use the sync function. It allows you to use looping without having to set a start and end point, because you set a start point and it knows where the end point's going to be. It lets you use effects which are based upon some kind of looping, so like an echo effect where each echo happens on the beat or on a factor of the beat. So having a good beat grid on all your tracks can be really useful in DJing. It can help you to be more creative because it takes a lot of the worry about keeping stuff in time off of your hands. But if the DJ software can't guess the beat grid, you're back to square one. And Tractor is notorious for not being able to do tracks which are not on the exact beat, like electronic music is, because it was made with a drum machine that's very regimented. there's a plus and a minus to that. The plus is that Traktor has got the very best beat gridding and sync and looping and effects tied to the beats. As long as the tracks you're using are electronic and they do have a beat that doesn't deviate at all. But unfortunately, when it does deviate a bit, Traktor's lost. The question is, why won't they implement it? I believe that, Traktor is a very old code base. In other words, it was written a long time ago, and it's just too hard to bring that kind of processing into the software the way it was written. And they haven't had the resource to rewrite it. That is my reading of it. But whatever the issue, you're not alone in wishing it weren't that way. But it is, unfortunately. So it's the best answer I can give you there. So apparently in South Africa, the clubs are pumping like nobody's business. It's great. Well, lucky somewhere has got that stuff going down, because it certainly isn't the case here. I mean, are you a DJ who's been playing gigs recently? Because certainly our DJ community in the US and the UK is saying, even when there's no lockdown, even when venues are open, they've been like 40, 50% down on the numbers, purely because people don't want to go out. They don't want to catch COVID before Christmas and be locked down at Christmas and all that kind of thing. So it's been, you know, hasn't been the massive return to normal that everyone was maybe hoping it would be. Please only ask your questions once, people. It will not be answered if I see it more than once at all. And it doesn't give you a better chance of getting your question answered, but it does mess up the timeline when I see the same things over and over again. So Ian says, do you know if anything else has changed with Engine DJ with the 2.1.1 update other than bug fixes? I didn't even know there was a 2.1.1 update of Engine DJ. It shows what I know. There's a 2.1 update, which has got some really good changes for Prime 4 users. It lets you use 4 decks. And it's got views where you can see all 4 waveforms at once. So well worth getting. And it's also updated to work with Monterey and Windows 11. Apart from that, I don't think there is a 1.1.1. It might have come out today. A 2.1.1. It might have come out today. But I don't know about that, Ian. Unfortunately, can't help you with that. George, how do I download my drivers for my Hercules 500 Impulse for my Serato Lite? If you're using Mac, you don't need drivers. If you're using Windows, you can get them from the Hercules website. So go, that's your first place to look on their website. That's always where you can find drivers. The next question is not even a question. It's just a Merry Christmas. All the way from Boston. Is it snowy there yet? Well, anyway, DJ Schooly AHD, thank you and welcome. Andy. Is there an option to migrate between Traktor, Serato, Rekordbox, etc.? Andy's on YouTube. Off you go, Mixmaster G. Help is on its way, Andy. Heriberto Botello. Feliz Navidad. Un gran abrazo a ti también, Heriberto. ¿Dónde está, mi amigo? Seda, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And to you. Hello, Cunha says hello, guys. And to you. Andy, is there an option to migrate? Oh, you've already asked that. Please do not ask your questions more than once. Real Life Bri, what's the best streaming platform for the Denon Prime 4? I've just purchased this controller and it's due for delivery tomorrow. So if you want to stream using the Denon Prime 4, you will need to plug your DJ unit's output, its audio output, into a laptop, probably best use a laptop, running software to broadcast that to the internet. There's no way of doing it directly from the unit. There should be. I wish they would do that, but not at the moment. So you need to plug into a laptop. And to do that, you'll need to use an audio interface, because there's no way of plugging digitally from the Prime 4 into a laptop. So you're going to want to get an audio interface. And I have some audio interfaces here. Here's a couple of examples of the kind of audio interfaces you can use. You can get very small audio interfaces like this one here. This is a little one from ReLoop, which have got a computer input on one side, a USB, and they've got these kind of inputs on the other. And you plug in your DJ controller here, and you plug in your computer there, and then you launch software on your laptop that lets you go live to the internet, to, you know, to Mixcloud and so on. And it will see the audio in that software. So you can just pad that audio in. And then here's another audio interface. This is a producer's audio interface. They do the same thing. So any audio interface, EverMix do a great one, Roland have got lots of nice little ones. Plug your audio into your computer, then you're going to need a camera. The best camera if you want to live stream your DJ set is probably a webcam, like a Logitech C922 is the one that we've used for years. Let me just show you a picture of the Logitech C922. They're about $60, maybe a little bit more. This is what they look like. Let's get some images up for you. This is a little Logitech camera. These are great. Get one of these, maybe a little tripod for it, plugged into your computer as well, and you will be able to go live with vision and really good quality audio with that audio interface. So that is the best way to do it. There's no real easier way to do that with a Prime 4, because unlike DJ software, like for instance Serato, you can just plug it into your laptop and you can then just run the audio and video into software running on the same laptop to go live with, but you are going to need a laptop to do that. So I hope that's helpful to you, real life Bri. Tom is another Prime 4 user. I picked up mine over the summer, and I'm just wondering if there's any way to get music into my internal hard drive without using Engine DJ software. No, you've got to use the software. Apparently, you can't hear us on Twitch, but you can in YouTube. Well, nothing I can do about that, I'm afraid. Other than say head over to YouTube, although you can't hear me if you're watching on Twitch. Any tips on how to improve my mic skills, especially how to connect with the crowd in a club or party? It's a good question, and again, your friend is Google for sure, because we've got lots and lots of articles to help you with this on digital DJ tips to talk you through how to do that. Head over to the website, click on the top corner. And just type in microphone and you'll find a few articles. There's a guide to microphones there. Conquering your microphone fear. This is one of the first ones that you should go and take a look at. And so you can see there's plenty of stuff here that can help you to get better on the microphone. I'd say this one here looks like a pretty good start, conquering your microphone fear. So it's all about being practiced. It's all about knowing who you're going to be talking to. And you can literally record yourself on your phone. Just grab your phone and prop it up somewhere and hold the hairbrush or whatever it is, a marker pen, a Sharpie, and record yourself. Hold your phone and literally just video yourself practicing on the mic. Looking into the camera, smiling. How are your shoulders? Are they like this, or have you learned to relax them? Are you speaking slowly enough? Are you looking at the floor when you talk? Are you mumbling? Is your mic staying in the right place? Or is it moving around? You know, look at all this stuff. Make videos of yourself practicing. And one of the biggest tips when you're talking on a microphone is to talk so slowly that you feel a bit stupid. Because in a situation where you're on a mic in a public space, that's what's needed for people to hear what you're saying. So, you know, would the person whose car is parked over the entrance please go and move it now? Sounds ridiculous, right? But that's because you and I are sat in a very intimate podcasting environment. Move that into a loud club, and the way I just did it would be correct. Any louder, you might mumble or people might miss what you're saying. And get people's attention before you say the important thing. It's okay to say, okay, everyone, may I have a second? And then nothing happens. And then you turn the music right off. Everyone, I need you for a second. Oi, including you at the back. Thank you. Listen up. And then say what you've got to say. Don't rush into what you've got to say, because if you're asked to do something on the microphone, there's no point not doing it because you were rushing and mumbling and talking too quickly. But practicing into like a hairbrush or something and videoing yourself, I think is the biggest tip for learning to use a microphone. And look at those articles on the website. Can anyone suggest the best large capacity thumb drive, says a brother named Sherm. We use these, the little stealth survivors. Now, I've heard people say, oh, they're really slow, they don't work very well with Pioneer gear and all that stuff. They've always been faultless for us. They come with a sheath that goes over there and screws on, and then you get this like bulletproof little cylinder. So that's the one I'm going to recommend to you. But some people prefer the little tiny ones. SanDisk have got some really nice small ones. Just get something that looks like it's going to last. You know, look for metal and look for protection for your USB plug, because it's going to break otherwise, right? It's not something you're just gently plugging into an office computer. They get a bit of abuse, DJ USBs. So do look for something that is useful but also durable. Happy 2022 to you too, Seda. So thumbs up for OBS here. OBS is a very simple way to go live, basically. It's a piece of software that's very similar to the one that I'm talking to you on now, but it's it is free. So I use software called Ecamm Live to talk to you guys and girls. But OBS is as I say, is very, very similar to Ecamm Live. And this is what it looks like. I will cut to OBS now and try and show you. First, I'm going to have to. There we go. So this is what it looks like. It's basically a it's an app which has got your cameras in it. Let me just try and get it to fit the screen a bit better there. There we go. So this is the camera that it's currently monitoring, although I could monitor myself there. Hello. All my cameras are down here, my microphones, my levels, and you just click start streaming. You get your streaming service set up here and you go live from within the software. It's very simple to use and it's for Mac and for Windows. So OBS is a good piece of software. It's something I would certainly recommend for you. I now need to get control back of my software because it's not been handed back to me yet from OBS. There we go. My Stream Deck shortcut machine is now working again. So thumbs up for OBS. If you want to start live streaming, don't pay for software. Get that one because it's free. So Chris has already entered the draw, the prize draw we were talking about. So good luck to you, Chris. Hello to UDJ, the people behind the Beatport DJ app, which is a fantastic app. Reza, I had a private gig on Saturday. And again, the song requests were wild. People were getting aggressive and coming to me telling me to play the same song twice. And yes, this gig was a disaster. I ended up using Spotify connected to an auxiliary. But do you have any tips on how to be in control and not have drunk people walking all over you? It is one of those things that DJs have always and will always complain about, requests. They can be useful. They can be helpful. But they can be a real pain. We have got loads and loads of stuff to help you here. Search for requests in Digital DJ Tips by clicking the little magnifying glass. And we've got how to handle requests, simple tips for handling requests, four ways to deal with bad song requests, specifically dealing with drunken teens at a house party. We have got, you will see over the years, we've covered so much on DJing requests. So go over there and have a browse there and just be, what's the word I'm looking for? Reassured that it's not just you and it's happened forever. And don't be too down on yourself, Reza. These things do happen. So apparently SanDisk Extreme or Samsung T5 or T7. But I think he was talking about a pen drive. No, maybe I mistook the question. But yeah, certainly if you're looking for a proper drive, if you like, one that you plug in separately with a lead, then there's some great examples there. Some of those are, I think, also. Anyway, you guys chat among yourselves. I'm not going to jump in and confuse you. You know what you're talking about. Jay, one quick question. How do you make comments on a track on the Denon DJ Prime 2? I can't apply the Energy Star rating or make a comment. You should be able to change the star ratings, I think, on the screen. I don't know, Jay, is the answer. Jay's on Facebook, so any Prime 2 users who can help Jay with Energy Star ratings or make... And I don't think you can add to the comments on the unit, but I think you can change the star ratings. I mean, you can certainly do it in the engine DJ software on your laptop, that's for certain. Apparently, there are many fake SanDisk drives out there, so be careful. How do we submit questions? You just type them into that chat box on YouTube where you are, Abraham. Mix... Master G, I just want to thank you. I'm going to thank Mixmaster G publicly for all your help this year on these live streams. You've been here for nearly all of them and really helped people out on their problems left, right and center with everything, not just the software you make. Mixmaster G makes the DJ conversion utility, DJCU software that helps you move your cue points and playlists and loops and so on between different DJ platforms. This is a question, another question. Lots of you are trying to live stream, which is an awesome thing to hear. This is from Don, who says, when I'm using the Mevo external audio inputs and switching between cameras, do you have to hook up more than one camera to your audio source? No, you can have it in. You can have it linked up to one camera. This is a special kind of camera, a Miro camera that lets you go live without a computer. And no, you can link it up to one camera, and they all know where the audio is coming from, Don. We were talking earlier about beat gridding, and I was saying how live drummers often don't stick to the tempo. And here's a great example from You Don't Like My Music, who says, when I recorded drums, I always made the engineer turn off the metronome because it was too distracting. A lot of drummers are asked to put headphones on in the studio while they're drumming, and the engineer will play a metronome or a click track that goes like this into the headphones to give the drummer something to play along to, because the drummer might not be the first person to be putting music onto the track. You know, they might have a finished track in the studio, but the drums weren't very good, so they got a different drummer in to put the drums on. So the drums have got to stay in line with the music, right? So, or it might be that the drums are going to be sequenced to electronic music in the studio afterwards, before, at the same time, or whatever. So the click track is there to keep the drummer basically on drum tempo. But some people don't like it. So that's a good example from You Don't Like My Music as to why you can't trust tracks with live drummers to stay on the beat, and why elastic beat gridding is a good idea in DJ software. Here's a question from Facebook and Alberto. Hey Phil, do you have any advice not to drink alcohol while we're DJing? Sometimes I feel more confident when I drink, and I'd like to achieve it without alcohol and avoid making mistakes that could cost me to lose gigs. It's a perennial issue, just like requests are. How much, if anything, should DJs drink? Now, I'm not going to stand here and say don't drink when you're DJing. I will say, if you are a wedding DJ, for instance, being paid many thousands to DJ someone's happiest day of their life, you should be stone cold sober beginning to end of that gig. If they offer you a glass of champagne, take a sip and put it down and don't finish it. Your job is to do the best job. But if you are a party DJ, a club DJ, and you're in a place where everyone's drinking and everyone's partying hard, it can feel almost saintly not to partake. But my rule always was, save the party until afterwards. It's all right to have a beer or two. One of my good friends, a DJ called Dave Haslam from Manchester, said to me once, I like to have a bottle of beer or two before my gig, just to take the edge off the fact that I'm twice the age of everyone on that dance floor. Dave was like 40 at the time. And take my mind off the fact that everyone is half my age in the club, right? So what he was really getting at is, it's all right to loosen up a tiny bit, but any more than that is going to start impacting your ability to do the job. So just maybe have a beer or two while you're playing. And then if you want a party, well, that's great, but do it afterwards, Alberto. But it is a problem for a lot of DJs that's been there. Again, it's one of those jobs, isn't it? That you're in an environment where other people are drinking, so there's always that temptation. This is from Helio, who says, do you think you'll have your courses in Portuguese? I'm afraid not. It's very difficult to get our courses into different languages. We have looked into it in the past, but we're sticking with English. Leslie, don't feel like you can't ask your question, Leslie. I'll decide if a question's too basic or not. So thank you for asking it. Leslie says, I'm a bit confused between the Serato DJ Pro software channel and the master levels when I'm using my Pioneer controller and channel the master levels. Is there a basic software level setting I can set so I can focus on controlling these levels through my controller? It is really confusing in DJ software, because the DJ software's got a master level which is often disconnected to the master control on your DJ controller. Here is the best way of doing it. The best way of doing it is to leave the auto gain on in your DJ software. That means the tracks coming into your controller are at the right volume, more or less, and then keep the levels on the master volume meters on your DJ controller out of the red, and then you'll be fine. Just don't think about anything else. Job done. Ignore the ones on the software. We could go into this into a lot more detail, but if you do that, you won't go wrong, Leslie. What's the best portable DJ controller for the money, says Jacobs. Well, that's a good question, because there's a lot of good portable controllers out there. These little controllers, this is an absolutely fantastic controller. I can show you this because it's on the shelf right next to me. The little ReLoop Ready. This was designed by DJ Angelo, our tutor. It's fantastic. It's a Serato controller. It's got all the pad controls that you get on Serato. It's got everything on it, all the effects controls. It really has got control over pretty much everything in Serato. And it's tidy. It's no bigger than a laptop computer. Certainly no bigger that way than a laptop computer. But it's expensive. It's like $350 or something. I think for the money, you can really not do much better than a Neumark Party Mix. Now, they're very basic controllers, but they're like $70. And they've got a light show on them. $70 or $80. They're probably about $400 now with a big, great gear shortage. But no, I'll see what they are. See what they are right now to buy. But they're very, very cheap. They're very good value, the little Neumark Party Mixes. Albeit they're not designed for, you know, truthful pro DJing or anything like that. Yep, guess what? It's not available at this moment, along with everything else, right? Let's have a look somewhere else. Yeah, here we go. £83 for the Neumark Party Mix 2, which is a really, really good price for a decent basic DJ controller. So if you're looking for value, that is what I would go for. That's about $110 US people, maybe $120, something like that. Anyway, not very much money. So that is probably the single best value DJ controller if you want something portable and cheap. So this is from, I'm looking for a question from someone who we haven't answered one before. Oh, this is a lovely one. Talking about the idea of drinking when you're DJing. Jay says, Mark says, drink low alcoholic drinks as in light beers or get taxied to and from gigs. Well, that does make sense. You know what? Years ago, my wife and I just got bored of drinking and we just, that's all we drink now, low alcohol or no alcohol beers. And you know what? You get home at the end of a busy week and you crack open a nice cold bottle of a decent low alcohol IPA. It just tastes like having a beer. Nowadays, I forget what it felt like to wake up with a hangover and I feel all the better for it. Mind you, it took a long, long time to figure that out. But yeah, thank you for that, Mark. This is from Angad, who says, I use Serato DJ Pro and I'm thinking of switching over to Rekordbox DJ. I'm thinking of getting the DDJ 1000. Is it worth it? I think that's what you're saying. Well, changing your DJ software is really difficult. If you want to continue being a controller DJ and use a laptop and DJ with a controller, and that's what you want to do, and you don't want to do anything else, then I would say it's pointless switching from Serato to Rekordbox for that reason. You might as well just buy the DDJ 1000 SRT, the Serato version, and continue to use Serato, because moving software is a big, big hassle. It really is. If you want to switch to Rekordbox because you want to work on your library and your playlists and then DJ with your laptop and your controller, but also export to USB drive so you can go and play in the clubs on their gear, well, now that's a different thing entirely. In that case, I would definitely say do it, because if you want to be a club DJ, you better get used to using Rekordbox if you want to turn up without a laptop. But in that instance, I would be tempted to buy a device like this one here, which is the XDJ RX3. And the reason for that is you can use it with your laptop as a Rekordbox controller, just like you're used to. But you can also use it as a standalone unit with USBs, because top right of your picture there, you can see the USBs are plugged in and that's what it's running from. It's not running from a laptop. So you get the best of both worlds, really. You get to practice. You get to use all the decent features of software, which has still got more features than standalone gear. But also you can practice using the kind of gear that you would use in a nightclub situation. So yeah, it really depends on what you want to switch to Rekordbox for. If you just like, the grass is always greener on the other side, I want to try other software, well, I'd hesitate there. People, we are live. It is Tuesday. It is our Tuesday Tips Live. We have got no agenda today. We've got no teaching points. We've got no gear to show you that's new. We've got no nothing to talk you through. It's just a Q&A to end 2021 with, because our next live is going to be 3 weeks today on Tuesday, the 11th of January, 2022. So there's going to be no Thursday Q&A live, no Tuesday Tips live for a well-earned Christmas break for us all here. So this is your last chance to get your questions in before we finish for the year. So do ask your questions. Apparently in Newcastle's good grief last Saturday, it was heaving. I used to Nice to know Barry, who started Good Grief all those years ago. Good to hear it's still going. Mark, Hard House Night, where it always was back then. So the next question I have here is from Jaffa, another Prime 4 user, Jaffa Ian. I'm DJing on the Prime 4 and using the link to Ableton Push 2. It's a great way to be creative on the fly. Anyone else tried this? No, but it is not with the Prime 4, but Ableton Push is a great controller, and the link between Ableton, for those of you that don't know, a lot of DJ gear, Denon DJ's standalone stuff, but also a lot of DJ software, has got links built into it, so you can just sync it with Ableton or with anything really, really easily. So you can have production gear running at the same time as drum machines and sequencers and DJ gear. Very, very clever, and very simple way of linking stuff up without using cables, just using the Wi-Fi network. Mark, what's the best laptop for using with the Pioneer CDJ 400? Doesn't matter about the gear. It's the best laptop for using with your DJ software that counts. If you go to your DJ software's I'm showing you now. This is for Serato, but it's the same on all DJ platforms. If you go to search their website, Serato, Traktor, Rekordbox, whatever, you'll find a page with the system requirements on it, and this will tell you what is needed in order to use it on different types of computer. So in this instance, we've got Mac and Windows down here, and it's telling you everything you need to know to do to buy the right laptop. Now, just because it's a minimum here, it doesn't mean it's recommended. It's always better to get a better specified laptop than the minimum. If it were me, and this is, you've asked me the question, so I'm going to give you the answer that I would give, if it were me, I would get a MacBook. You can run all DJ software on an M1 Mac nowadays, and it's super fast. You can have a MacBook Air, no problem. But that said, you can get some great Windows computers. Just buy one that looks like it's going to last, because the difference between MacBook and Windows is that you can't get a cheap Mac computer. So they're all basically built pretty well with decent cases and so on. So just get one that feels like the same kind of quality as an Apple computer. And I would say stick with AMD processors. Only historically, I've always said that because there's always, sorry, rewind. Stick with Intel processors. AMD processors have traditionally had little problems with the some DJ software. But having said that, I haven't really heard too much recently about problems with AMD. So maybe you'll be all right. But yeah, just make sure it's well built. That's the real thing. All right then, so let's continue with our questions. We are live, and I'm going to stick here for another 10 minutes or so to answer everything you're asking. Here's the big one of the year. When will retailers have Pioneer controllers in stock? We just don't know. It's just a terrible time at the moment. I mean, I can't see this issue going away in 2022. Honestly, think it's going to be a year or two before this gets sorted out. And I, yeah, don't know. Strange times. But really, get it ordered is the key. Once your orders are in, then at least you're in the queue. We're talking about audio interfaces, weren't we? You don't like my music, says the iRig Stream for $100. Sounds great for the price. Yep, iRig Stream is actually what we've got down here underneath this desk here is all wired up, and the microphone, there's the microphone for this desk, and the music and everything goes underneath that desk, and it goes into an iRig Stream, which is a tiny little audio interface with lots of inputs. So that's what we use when we're over in the production workshop side of the studio to go live through. So yep, I can also agree with the iRig Stream being good. This is a good question. What's a good program for removing duplicate songs from Rekordbox? Is there a program for that? The reason you've got duplicates in your DJ software is very likely because you've got duplicates on your computer. So what you really want to be doing is finding where the duplicates are and deleting them from your computer. Then go back into your DJ software and rescan your tags, and suddenly it won't be able to find all the things you've deleted. And then you can sort your DJ library in your DJ software so that all the stuff it can't find is in one chunk, and then just highlight it all and delete it. Your DJ software normally won't copy your music anywhere. It will just reference where it is. So if it's found more than one copy of something, it's probably because you have got more than one copy of something. So, you know, sort out the problem at source rather than within your DJ software. So the question about the mixer was about using it with a DJ controller so you can have more microphone inputs. Ah, okay. So what Blue Boy was asking is, and I'll show everyone else. Blue Boy had referenced a mixer. This is a mixer. These are called live mixers. These are the kind of mixers that musicians use. Blue Boy referenced a bigger one with bigger faders and stuff, but basically something like this, and said, is it possible to use something like this to plug in microphones and maybe other instruments or whatever, and then from there plug into your DJ controller so you've got more stuff going into your DJ performance? Absolutely, Blue Boy. It's absolutely possible. It's a classic use of a second mixer to do exactly what you just said. As long as your DJ controller has got an auxiliary input or a line input that you can use, you can't really plug from a mixer like that into the microphone input. You probably could. You could probably have a low output coming from that mixer and a low output on the microphone and get away with it, but I wouldn't like to do that. So as long as you've got a line level input on your mixer, your DJ controller, yes, you could definitely do that. These kind of mixers are a really good thing to have knocking around. This is quite a big one, but there's smaller ones. You can get mixers about half the size of this that have got like four inputs and two outputs and a few EQ controls. They're just a little Swiss Army knife that I recommend every DJ own, because it just will get you out of all kinds of situations. It'll help you when you're playing with other DJs or musicians, or you're trying to rig up something in your studio in order to get a drum machine into what you're doing because someone's lent you one or whatever. A little mini mixer is a great thing to have knocking around. And again, they're not very expensive to buy. Kyle is over there in Alabama. I was wondering if I can still use the functionality of my laptop when I'm hooked up with a controller. I've been a DJ for 32 years, but I haven't made the controller jump yet. Yes, you certainly can. So if you're using a laptop with DJ software, with all DJ software, you can actually do everything on the laptop, apart from the lack of an audio interface, because DJ controllers have got nice controls, but they've also got an audio interface in them, which is how you get your headphones and your speakers all plugged in together. Apart from the lack of that, running your DJ software using a laptop is all perfectly possible. And you can use the shortcuts to do everything, to load, to queue, to speed up, to slow down, to mix, to add effects, to loop. Everything can be done on keyboard shortcuts. And just because you then plug a DJ controller in doesn't mean that all that stops working. That will all still work fine, which is really good news, because, you know, you often see DJs when they're using a laptop and DJ software and a controller not using the knobs on the controller to select. Like, for instance, on this one here, we've got a knob here for choosing your track. Right? And all DJ controllers have got knobs for choosing tracks. But a lot of the time, DJs just use the computer keyboard to quickly search for something and the mouse to drag it onto a deck. And then they go back to their controller itself, and that's fine. And there's other, I was just thinking then about other things you might use it for. A lot of controllers don't have some of the controls you might want. Like a really good one is, there's a mode called slip mode. Slip mode, again, it's on this one here. It's here. Slip mode is a control which lets you like do some scratching, some cue point stuff, some spin backs, messing around with the deck. And as soon as you finish, the track will continue where it would have been had you not touched anything. It's a really good way of adding a bit of flair to your sets, but without interrupting the flow of the music. And a lot of controllers don't have it on, but I find it really useful. So it's always easy to MIDI map a slip control to a button on your laptop. So if you want to turn that on and off, you just use your laptop to do it. And so, yes, you can continue to use your laptop. And I would thoroughly recommend you to do this. Kyle, hello, Kyle. Merry Christmas from Alabama. Oh, no, we just answered you. Sorry, Kyle. Lionel, in Engine, a lot of Denon users here today. In Engine, is there a way to identify songs as clean or explicit? I'm stuck making playlists in Rekordbox using color tags for pink, clean, red, explicit, then importing the clean or explicit. What I would do is make playlists. I would have playlists that have got the clean and explicit versions in, and then they can come across into your DJ platform, whichever platform you're using, to kind of get around that one. This is from Chris. We were talking about microphones earlier, weren't we? Chris says, every time I speak into the mic, I try to smile or laugh as I'm talking. It helps me to feel more relaxed. Yep, forcing a smile onto your face, as I'm doing, I'm not forcing it now, but you know what I mean, will certainly help you to come across. And, you know, talking on a mic is something that you can fake. People don't care how nervous you are. They just want to hear what you've got to say. So if you can tell yourself to, you can move around on your feet, drop your shoulders, smile a bit, and then just trying to stay in that way. Because you see people like not blinking, don't you? Hello, welcome everyone. And their shoulders are tense and they're every muscle in their body, including their fists, white knuckled, and they're not blinking and they're certainly not looking at you. They're looking at the wall behind you about 15 foot up it. You know, you can tell yourself not to do that stuff. Even if you're feeling like that's the last thing you want to do, relax. So yeah, good point. Thank you for that. Ian says, practicing into headphones. You can actually use headphones as a microphone, but I wouldn't recommend it. You can indeed. You plug a pair of headphones into a microphone socket. And I think it's the left-hand one will always work as a microphone. So that's something that everyone works out at some point or other. This more microphone advice from Luis. Focus, smile, excite your public and have fun. It's the best way to MC. I've been doing it for over 30 years. It still works. So there we go. And a good way around requests, an elevated DJ booth with a ladder. Yeah, I used to have a DJ booth with a lock on the door. That, I really like that one. But of course, we don't always have that. Hava says, I have the MixStream Pro. Is there a sampler I can use with it as it doesn't have a built-in one? Yeah, what I would do is just go and get a sampler app for your phone and then get the adapter leads to get headphones out from your phone, plug it into the auxiliary input on the MixStream Pro. Job done. Simple as that. Don't ask your questions more than once, please. My team is trying to stop you doing that as well, people. It's basic manners. So Kyle is pointing out that Steely Dan used different drummers and other artists with different tracks. Yeah, in the studio, it's often the case that musicians get switched out because the people weren't used to the, you know, didn't like the musicians in the performance and they got switched out. And therefore that click track is often quite important for keeping in time. That's what we were talking about, weren't we? We were talking about keeping in time. Philip is a new digital DJ. Looking forward to getting your DDJ 800. I've been a DJ for 20 years and never used Rekordbox. Well, good luck, Philip. Do let us know how you get on. Live questions, a few more before I go. Lots of people chatting about drinking. David says, I used to think I DJed better when I was drinking. Dot, 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 dot. Then I listened to my performance and felt differently. No drinking for me while performing. So there we go. How does Carl Cox play 8 hours and not need the loo? Who knows? He's certainly not drinking pints of beer, that's for certain. And that's something that you don't like my music points out as well. You'll be constantly going to the toilet if you're drinking, unless you have diapers. I think we'll leave it there. Digital Nation's got a good question. Anything or any bits of gear you're looking forward to next year? I'm really looking forward to Pioneer DJ innovating a bit more around its standalone gear. I think they will be doing it next year. I've got no insider knowledge of that, but I think they will be innovating to kind of get their gear where it can be, because some of their standalone gear, even this, which is going to do really well, is a little bit behind the times as far as what features you get are, certainly compared to the Denon DJ gear. So I'm looking forward to more innovation from Pioneer DJ on their gear. And I'm also looking forward to more innovation in streaming. And one thing I really, really want to happen is I want Apple Music to let DJ software use its streaming service, because I just think that once iTunes is all opened up, including streaming music in DJ software, it'll help a lot more DJs, and I think that'll be fun. I'm not saying that they will ever do it. I suspect they won't, but it'll be really nice. Roger, here's a great question. You got me thinking now, Roger. Have you heard any news about a potential motorized version of the Denon LC6000? Let's talk about the LC6000 for a second. I'll go and grab one. Don't know where they've all gone, people. Here's one. Just pulling it out from the drawers. Right, this is a Denon DJ LC6000. This is a really interesting controller, and it is a controller. It's got no audio on the back. See, there's no audio inputs or outputs. There's literally just a USB. This is a controller. It's a control deck. It's got a deck, and it's got some cue points. It's got play pause. It's got a touch strip, and it's got a knob for library control. And that's more or less it. There's a loop control there as well. This is designed to work with Denon DJ's big media players, the ones with big screens on, because their media players can control two decks. Unlike Pioneer DJ's CDJ 3000s, Denon DJs can each control two decks. But they've only got one platter. So the idea is you buy one of the big ones and you put one of those controllers next to it, so you've got two decks in one. Really cheap, well, it's not cheap, but a cheaper way of getting a four-deck system. You buy two proper media players and two of those add-on LC6000s. But of course, Denon DJ makes motorized and non-motorized decks. They call them the SC6000 and the SC6000M. So the question is, logically, is there going to be a motorized version of the LC6000? And I think, I've never thought of that, and it's a reasonably obvious thing to think of. I don't know. I mean, part of the appeal of the LC6000 is it's quite cheap. So as soon as they stick a motor in it, it won't be so cheap. But it would be a direct competitor to the Rain 12, although the Rain 12 is more like a turntable the way it's set up. I don't know. Interesting. They did, wouldn't it? But I don't have any info on that other than guesswork. But it'd be good to see that, wouldn't it? MacBook Air base model, 850 on Apple Refurb. That is a steal, says Digital Nation. We were talking about MacBooks for DJing there. Honestly, it doesn't matter what you use for DJing. All platforms are perfectly capable of doing it. Although it's just a personal choice. I mean, it would really be, if you already use Windows or Mac somewhere in your life, I would say stick to that just to keep it all nice and simple. What's the best software to use for DJing? Keith? Digital DJ Tips website is your friend here. Go to Digital DJ Tips. Go to the little sign at the top and type software. And then best DJ software 2022. We go through them all there, or rather all the big ones. So you come and have a look at this article and you'll find not only all the big pieces of DJ software rounded up with links to reviews and so on and what you're looking for, but lots and lots of really interesting comments from the community at the bottom to help you decide as well. So do come and have a look. Just go and search for software by using the magnifying glass at the top and we can help you there. People, I'm gonna get out of here now. Sorry for everyone whose questions I couldn't answer, but it's, as always, been very busy. It's our last show of 2021. So I'd just like to say from me, from Steve, from Ben and Scott and Faye and Juanmi and the rest of the team here at Digital DJ Tips, thank you very, very much for being a part of our community and for being a part of these broadcasts in 2021. We only do this because of you. And we know there's other things you could be doing with your time. So especially to all our regulars, but also to everyone else who's tuned in, whether you're watching this live or whether you're watching the replay, I hope we've been able to help you. I hope we've been able to inspire you. And we look forward to another year of doing just that next year in 2022, including welcoming our latest tutor with his brand new course, DJ Jazzy Jeff, which is happening at the beginning of 2022. So do keep your eyes open for that. Meanwhile, have a wonderful holiday period wherever you are. Enjoy Christmas if you're celebrating it. Enjoy your new year. Enjoy your gigs over this time. And from all of us here at Digital DJ Tips, if you can, get good, get out there and make the moments. And until next time, all the best to all of you and your families. Bye-bye.